Should you support Internet Explorer in 2022 and beyond? Absolutely not. Well, that is the short answer. And the long answer is no, you probably shouldn't support it, except in some really rare marginal cases. In this video, I will outline in general how to think about browser support, how to decide if you want to support or drop support for certain browsers, and I will give you some pointers on some arguments you can make with your managers, stakeholders, clients, whoever it is that wants you to support a browser that is clearly not worth your time, effort, or the energy. All right, a first thing that you should consider when you're thinking about whether you should support a certain browser or not is the usage of that particular browser. And there are some good resources on the web that you can employ. And one of those resources is StatCounter. You will find it at gs.statcounter.com, and the link is going to be in the description. And right here, we see the average browser market share worldwide. And if we look at the data here, you can see that Chrome is the most popular browser, followed by Safari, which is mainly due to iPhone, and then the other browsers follow. And Internet Explorer, in our case, is going to be at 0.57%, so it's really, really small amount of people that are still using Internet Explorer. So if you're thinking, should I support this browser or that browser, Internet Explorer, or maybe Firefox, maybe Edge, you can open this page and you're going to see the numbers right here. This is how many people are using those browsers, and well, if the number is not insignificant, you definitely do want to support that. This is going to vary because this is usage worldwide. Now, if you're creating a web page or an app that is localized, that is specifically designed for a certain market, for a certain country, you might want to dig into this data to see if there is a difference for your particular country that you want to support, that you want your app to be available in. So you can do that if you just go right here and, for example, select Europe, and you're gonna see that browser market share in Europe should be pretty similar to the global browser market share, but it might differ a little bit. Depending on the country you're in, it might differ a lot. So even though those numbers here are not so different, you wanna make sure to select the most appropriate audience you wanna support to ensure that you have a very good overview of which browsers are used and in what percentages. But of course, these are just general numbers, and general numbers don't tell you a lot. Ideally, you want to make sure to consult your own analytics. If you're using Google Analytics or some kind of alternative, for CSS Weekly, for example, I'm using Plausible Analytics, and I can go right here and explore what percentage of my own visitors are actually using Internet Explorer or some other browsers, and I can conclude from there if I need to support or if I need to optimize my website for those particular browsers. So I have a number of devices here that visitors of CSS Weekly have used in the previous year. And as you can see, there is no Internet Explorer on the list. And this essentially means for my use case that there's very, very few people that potentially use Internet Explorer to visit CSS Weekly. So it would be a waste of my time and resources because those other browsers are much more represented and much more popular within my audience. So whenever you're thinking about support, think about browser market share in general, and think about, if you can, more specifically about browser share within your own analytics, and optimize your web for the browsers that your visitors are actually using. And now, for our particular example of Internet Explorer, we can go even further. And number one thing that I want to mention is that Internet Explorer is an end-of-life product, or with the June of 15th, 2022, Microsoft will no longer support Internet Explorer, or specifically for select editions of Windows 10, including the retail version found on many home computers. Internet Explorer 11 is no longer supported as of June 15, 2022. And that is exactly at the time of publishing of this video. So what I understand is if people try to open after that particular date Internet Explorer, they're gonna automatically be redirected to Microsoft Edge, which means that Internet Explorer usage will drop even more. So it's gonna be even less people who visit various web pages on the internet using Internet Explorer. And that is fantastic news, and definitely a clear sign that there's no reason to support Internet Explorer anymore. But of course, as we mentioned, if your analytics are telling you a different story, if for some reason your visitors are still using Internet Explorer, you will still wanna make sure to give them a basic experience so they can access your site. And that is actually the first point that I wanna make. If somebody, for some reason, insists that you still support Internet Explorer or some other browser that is clearly not represented within your visitors, you can explain to them this is an end-of-life product. Users who are trying to use it will automatically be redirected to Microsoft Edge. So even if our analytics is telling us a different story, we still might want to consider that Internet Explorer will drop significantly in usage, and we probably do not want to support it. If that's not good enough, you can go one step further. You can mention all the big names, big brands that have stopped supporting Internet Explorer, big brands that your clients or managers are probably using daily. Sites like YouTube, Twitter, Facebook all stopped supporting Internet Explorer, and that is a pretty good sign that there's not a lot of people who actually visit websites in Internet Explorer anymore. So if companies that have pretty much unlimited resources in their development departments, if they are not supporting it, what is the reason for us to support it? How can we afford to support Internet Explorer? Another convincing argument you can make if you don't want to support, if you think you shouldn't support Internet Explorer, is security. Or Internet Explorer is not a secure browser. It's not as secure when it's compared to something like Chrome or Microsoft Edge or Firefox or any other modern browser. And if it's not secure, then you definitely don't want visitors to visit in it in that insecure browser. It's risk for them, and it's definitely not a good look on you if something happens to them while they're coincidentally browsing your website in an outdated insecure browser like Internet Explorer. So for that particular case, you could add some kind of a notice to the website that says something like, "We noticed you're using Internet Explorer. This is not a secure browser. Please switch to a different modern browser, Microsoft Edge or Chrome or whatever. It's faster, it's better, it's safer, it's modern, and you're gonna have a much better experience browsing the web using that browser than Internet Explorer that you're currently using. Please consider switching to a different browser." And that would be a good idea, a good experience for potential users that still come using Internet Explorer to your website or any other browser that you don't particularly want to support for this reason or that reason. And lastly, building up on our knowledge from the browser stats, from the analytics, you can say, all right, for so many people, if for some reason 1% or less than 1% people is visiting our website in Internet Explorer, do we really want to waste our resources, development time, money essentially, to support an outdated, insecure browser? This will increase our development cost by maybe 20, maybe 40%, because Internet Explorer doesn't support modern features. So we're gonna have to develop a strategy on how to either use modern features and do something as an alternative, like a polyfill or something, to support Internet Explorer users, or we shouldn't use modern features, modern APIs, and then use older browser features that are not ideal, not optimal, that are much more difficult to develop in, which again increases the cost, builds up frustration in developers, in your users, and so on and so on. So that is one of the strong arguments you can make whenever somebody wants you to support a browser that is clearly not on a list of browsers that people who are visiting your website or who are browsing the web in general are using. So if somebody comes with a request or a question about Internet Explorer, about an outdated browser, don't say to them, "We don't support that," period. Explain them the reasoning behind it. Explain them why you're not supporting it. It's insecure. Users are no longer using it. There's significant downside in the development cost. And with those arguments in place, I don't think that a lot of people are going to make an argument that they still want to support Internet Explorer or rather any other browser that you don't want to, that you don't support any longer. I hope this gives you a little bit of insight into what to think about when you're trying to decide if you want to support or drop support for a certain browser, like Internet Explorer in our case, and additionally, how you can represent your case to the stakeholders, to managers, clients, whoever it is that insists you support a browser that is clearly not on a list of browsers that you should be focusing. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in the next video, but not in Internet Explorer.